Under the effective interest method of bond discount or premium amortization, the periodic interest expense is equal to option A stated, or we can say nominal rate of interest multiplied by the face value of the bonds, option B the market rate of interest multiplied by the face value of the bonds, option C the interest stated rate multiplied by the beginning of period carrying amount of the bonds, option D the market rate multiplied by the beginning of period carrying amount of the bonds. So here the solution will be option D, the market rate multiplied by the market rate multiplied by the beginning of period carrying amount of the bonds, because under the effective interest rate method, the amount of interest expense in a given area will correlate with the amount of bonds carrying value. This implies that when a bond's book value decreases, the amount of interest expense will decrease periodically. So the answer is market rate multiplied by the beginning of period carrying amount of the bonds.